Continuing with part 1, fifth point is selection of analytical method for the analysis of combination drugs. Now in UV spectrophotometry, if you want to analyze a combination of drug, various methods are available like simultaneous equation method, derivative spectrophotometric method, absorbance ratio method, also called as Q-absorbance method, difference spectrophotometric method. Now let's we see how we can go with the development of analytical method in UV for a combination drug. The first is simultaneous equation method. Suppose a sample contains a two compound X and Y and both absorbs at the lambda max of each other. For such combination, it is possible to estimate both the compounds by technique called simultaneous equation or Viroditz method. The total absorbance of a solution at a given wavelength is equal to the sum of absorbance of the individual component at the wavelength. Simultaneous equation works on this principle that the total absorbance of a solution at a given wavelength, your solution contains a mixture of both the drug at a given wavelength, is equal to sum of absorbance of individual component at the wavelength. So it is simple summation of absorbance of both the drug. Suppose Cx and Cy are the concentration of X and Y in diluted sample. So at wavelength 1, the absorbance of a mixture, this is individual spectra, if it is a mixture of X and Y, the absorbance of a mixture is a summation of absorbance due to compound X and absorbance due to compound Y. Similarly, at second wavelength, the absorbance of mixture is due to absorbance of compound X at second wavelength and absorbance of compound Y at second wavelength, where AX1 and AX2, AX1 and AX2 are the absorptivity of compound X at wavelength 1 and wavelength 2. Similarly, AY1 and AY2 are the absorptivity of Y at lambda 1 and lambda 2, and A1 and A2 are the absorbance of a sample containing combination of drug at both the wavelength. Now, if we rearrange the equation 2, that is Cy is equal to A2 minus AX2 Cx bracket complete upon AY2. If we substitute Cy in equation 1 and rearrange it, we'll have these equations. Now, these equations are used to find out concentration of X and concentration of Y using simultaneous equation, where AY1 and AY2 are the absorptivities of Y and AX2 and AX1 are the absorptivities of X. So if we find out absorptivity of compound X and compound Y at both the wavelength, and if we substitute in these equations, the only unknown terms are A2 and A1, that is the absorbance of sample at first and second wavelength. So, using this equation, we can find out the concentration of X and concentration of Y. Now, by using this method, if you want to have a proper precision and accuracy, the ratio of A2 upon A1, that is absorbance of sample at second and first wavelength ratio, upon AX2 upon AX1, and similarly AY2 upon AY1 upon A2 upon A1 should lie outside the range of 0.122. Second, the lambda max of two components should be dissimilar. It means that they should not be too close. At least a 20 nanometer difference should be there. And the third requirement is two components do not interact chemically. That we need to check. So that is the use of simultaneous equation. Now, the second method is Q-absorbance method. This method assumes that the ratio of absorbance at any two wavelength is a constant value independent of concentration. So for example, two different dilution of the same compound gives same absorbance ratio A1 upon A2 at two different wavelength. So if we find out the absorbance ratio at two different wavelength for the same compound, the ratio will remain constant. In this method, two wavelengths are selected for combination drug, where one is the lambda max of one of the component. For example, for drug X, lambda 2 is selected as wavelength maxima, and the another wavelength selected is isoabsorptive point, that is this one, where both the spectra crosses. Here many students make a mistake that it should be isoabsorptive point. So the spectra taken should be from the same concentration of both the drug. It cannot be of different concentration. So that is isoabsorptive point. Find out the isoabsorptive point, that is your lambda 1. And second is lambda 2, that is the wavelength maxima of one of the drug. And two equations are constructed. For in this instance, AX1 and AY2, AX1 and AY1 are equal and the path length is 1 cm. So our equation will be A1 is equal to AX1 CX plus AX1 CY. Here also AX1 is written because AX1 and AY1 are same. So A2 upon A1 is equal to AX2 CX plus AY2 CY bracket complete upon AX1 CX plus AX1 CY. Now if we divide each term by CX plus CY and let the Fx is equal to CX upon CX plus CY and Fy is CY upon CX plus CY, then we will have this equation. But as we know, Fy is equal to 1 minus Fx. So A2 upon A1 is equal to AX2 Fx minus Fx AY2 plus AY2 bracket complete upon AX1. Let Qx is ratio of absorptivity of drug X, that is AX2 upon AX1, and Qy is AY2 upon AY1, and Qm is A2 upon A1. So if we put these values in above equation, and we will have Qm is equal to Fx in the bracket Qx minus Qy plus Qy. So Fx is equal to in the bracket Qm minus Qy upon Qx minus Qy. So equation 1 is written as A1 is equal to AX1 in the bracket CX plus CY. So CX plus CY is equal to A1 upon AX1. And from equation 2, we will have this derived formula. So above equation gives the concentration of X in terms of absorbance ratio, the absorbance of mixture and the absorptivities of compound at the isoabsorptive wavelength. And that is how we can determine the concentration of drug X. Now this concentration is kept in this equation where we know the value of CX. We have to determine the value of CY. We know the absorbance value at first wavelength and we know AX1. So from that, CY can also be calculated. So CY will be A1 upon AX1 minus CX. So this is how concentration of X and Y is calculated in Q absorbance method. Moving to third method, that is derivative spectroscopy. It is a method of manipulating the spectral data to perform the analysis of mixture. Derivative spectrophotometry involves conversion of normal spectra to its first, second or higher derivative spectrum. The normal absorption spectra like this one is called zero order or D0 spectra, also called as fundamental spectra. Now these spectra are mathematically converted into first derivative. For example, the first derivative D1 spectrum It is a plot of rate of change of absorbance, that is dA, upon d lambda, that is with wavelength, against wavelength. So dA upon d lambda versus wavelength. Change of absorbance with wavelength against wavelength. So we will have this spectra. The wavelength maxima in zero order spectra will cross the zero point in first order spectra. The second derivative spectra, that is D2 spectra, is a plot of curvature of D0 spectra against wavelength, or it is a plot of D square A upon D lambda square versus lambda, and we will have this kind of graph. A derivative spectra offers advantage of better resolution of overlapping bands than the zero order spectra. Now let's see how we'll develop a method using derivative spectrophotometry. Prepare a solution of both the drugs in a solvent suitable and take their derivative spectra individually and overlap these spectras. Find out a zero crossing point called ZCP, where one drug is having zero absorbance while the other drug gives appreciable absorbance. Similarly, find out the ZCP of second drug, where the absorbance of second drug is zero and the first drug is showing appreciable absorbance, and plot a graph calibration curve at these two wavelengths and check that first drug gives ZCP at all the concentrations and second drug shows appreciable absorbance, giving linear response. Similarly, the process can be repeated for the second drug. This carry out this procedure in first order derivative responses. If it do not give a proper wavelength, then the same procedure can be repeated using second order derivative spectra. So this is how in second order derivative spectroscopy we can develop a method. Now, all the amplitude in derivative spectrum are proportional to the concentration of analyte. The resolution increases with increase in derivative order. However, noise also increases, so normally it is preferred to work with first and second order derivative spectra. Fourth is difference spectrophotometry. Difference in absorbance between two electronic form of the same compound in two different conditions are measured. In this method, instead of blank, one of the two solution is kept and the other solution is kept in the place of sample. For example, phenobarbital can be estimated by difference spectroscopy. Prepare the same concentration of drug in two different solvents, 0.1 normal HCl and 0.1 normal NaOH. This is for example, and absorbance difference is measured by putting 0.1 normal HCl in a sample compartment and 0.1 normal NaOH containing drug in a blank compartment. Similarly, absorbance difference is measured at different concentrations and this difference is plotted against wavelength. The concentration of unknown is determined in a similar way by measuring absorbance and determining the concentration. So this is how various methods can be used to analyze drug, combination of drug using UV spectrophotometry. Now, the next, after selecting a solvent, after selecting a proper derivatizing methods, after selecting a wavelength maxima, the next point is validation of developed analytical method. So carry out validation of developed analytical method using either ICH or USP guideline, and then apply this developed method for dosage form analysis, bulk analysis, or dissolution method, or any other way. So this is how UV spectroscopic methods can be developed.